Scientists identified a group of people who had the disease but showed no viral level of HIV.
Reporter Dina Baer is explaining how scientists are hoping this new finding might play a role in fighting COVID-19.
Massive numbers of people in the Democratic Republic of Congo are infected with HIV. A select group doesn't show it.
We found that there were actually a large number of patients who didn't have any virus to even sequence.
Abbott scientists have been tracking the virus that causes AIDS since 1985 in 45 different countries. In all, 76 million have been infected. 38 million are currently living with HIV. 26 million are in Africa, and that's where the superfighters with no detectable virus live now.
We found that there were about 4% of all the people with HIV and DRC who are able to naturally control HIV without taking any medication.
What's in their DNA that boosts their immunity? That's the next focus for research.
We have so many people that we can now follow and understand what makes them unique and see clear trends that we could more easily translate into new treatments and vaccines. This could be groundbreaking if these people are able to potentially teach us how to suppress HIV.
The quest is similar in the desperate search for answers in the current pandemic fighting SARS-CoV-2.
We've taken what we've learned about how we need to be able to detect a lot of different strains of HIV with just one diagnostic test, and that's taught us how to make a test for SARS-CoV-2 that can detect all the many new variants that we're now seeing.
Working together has been the key, battling a virus that first hit the stage in the 1980s to the one that upended our lives in 2020. Collaboration has yielded answers and hope.
The ability to respond as quickly as the scientific community has by creating diagnostic tests really quickly and generating vaccines and potentially, you know, some therapies as well with antibodies now being in use. So it's really nice to see how quickly the scientific community has responded. And so I'm very optimistic that everything we're doing is going to help us make significant decreases in the number of COVID cases.